In our last video, we saw the definition of closed sets and saw that they could be actually very complicated. Now let's work on a few properties. The first theorem that we were working with is this one. When looking at this theorem, try and remember the definition of a topology. You will find that these two are very similar. So you have X, a topological space, that is X with a topology, and the following conditions will always hold. The empty set and X are closed. We kind of saw this one in the last video. So this one we have already proved. Then it says that arbitrary intersections of closed sets are closed. If you go back to the definition of a topology, we had that arbitrary unions of open sets were open, because arbitrary unions of elements in our topology, the open sets, are in our topology, so are open sets. Here we have intersections, so we are changing unions for intersections, and open for closed. And finally, finite unions of closed sets are closed. This one is also very similar to the one we had. We said that finite intersections of open sets were open. To prove this theorem, all we need will be that definition of a topology, because it's actually the only hypothesis we have. Now let's go ahead and prove the theorem. The first one, as I said, we proved it in our previous video. And the proofs of 2 and 3 are actually very simple. Arbitrary intersections of closed sets are closed. For this, let's take F alpha, just an arbitrary collection of closed sets. We want to see if the intersection of these closed sets is also closed. To prove that a set is closed, we know that we have to take the complement. So we will do X minus the intersection, so the actual set that we want to prove. And now, using the Morgan's law, we know that we can write this as the union of the complements. But now, because each F alpha was closed, we know that X minus F alpha is open. And this will happen for every alpha. So these are all open sets, and we are taking the arbitrary union of open sets. By the definition of a topology, we know that this is open. And so, because X minus the intersection is an open set, then all this is closed. Well, very similarly, we'll prove the third one. Finite unions of closed sets are closed. So let's take a finite collection of closed sets. And now we will do the same. To prove that the union is closed, just take X minus the union. And we have to prove that this is an open set. But now, again, using the Morgan's law, this is the intersection of X minus Fi. And these are all open sets. So, using the definition of a topology, finite intersections of open sets are open, and thus we have that this is closed. So, the theorem was actually very simple, and it made sense because of the Morgan's law that we could change the terms in the definition of a topology with these other terms. So this is actually giving us something very important, and is we define the topology with open sets and those three properties that we have in the definition. But we could have done all the same with this, just defining closed sets and saying that a collection of subsets of X is a topology if it satisfies these three properties. This is the intention of the first exercise in the section of closed sets in Mancre's book. If we had done that, we would have exactly the same results. The reason why it's not done like this is because nobody uses it like that. Every book, you see, defines topology in the way we have and works all the time with open sets. So it's now sort of standardized, but it would be exactly the same thing. Let's move on to the second property about closed sets. Now we have a subspace of a topological space and a closed set in that subspace. We say that this set is closed if and only if it's the intersection of a closed set of X with Y. So this is kind of resembling what we had for open sets. Remember that a set A is open in Y if and only if A was the intersection of Y with an open set in X. U was an element in topology of X, and then we have this. So now it's giving us sort of the same result for closed sets. A set will be closed in Y if it's the intersection of Y with a closed set of X. So we will have the same as closed here and closed here. Let's prove it. We have an if and only if, so we have to prove both directions. Let's start with this direction. So we have that a set A is the intersection of Y with F, and F is a closed set in X. I can write A as the intersection of a closed set of X with Y, and I have to prove that this set A is closed in Y. So I have to prove that Y minus A is open. Now, because F is a closed set in X, then we have that X minus F is open. So let's make a drawing about what we have. Let's say that this is our space X. Somewhere here we have our set Y, and we said that we took some set F closed in X, and the intersection with Y we called it A. So just take some F like this, a closed set on X, and this inner part we just call it A. We want to prove that A is closed in Y. So let's think about Y minus F. Y minus F is open, and it's essentially all this. So because it's an open set in X, then our set Y intersection X minus F, because we're working with the subspace topology on Y, this is an open set. It's an open set in Y because it's the intersection of an open set in X with Y. And this set, let me delete all these lines, this set is this part here. Because it was all that complement intersection Y. So you can see that it's the complement of A in Y. We have that Y intersection X minus F is actually Y minus A. And we said that this set was open. So then this set is open. And then this proves that A is closed. Now let's try and prove the other direction. That is, we have a closed set in Y, and we have to prove that we can write it as the intersection of Y with a closed set of X. So let's take A, a closed set of Y. I want to prove that I can write A as Y intersection, let's call it G, for some G closed in X. Now, because A is closed in Y, then Y minus A is open in Y. This is just because of the definition of a set being closed. And because Y minus A is open in Y, because we're working with the subspace topology, this means that Y minus A is the intersection of our space with some open set U in X. This is the definition of a set being open in the subspace topology. So again, let's draw the situation. We have our space X, our subspace Y, and what we're saying is that there is an open set in X, let's call it like this, U, such that the complement of this set was the set we started with, A. So now if you think about it, A will be the intersection of all this without my set U. So if I take all the green section, that is X minus U, and intersect it with Y, this gives us my set A. So A is actually X minus U, so the green section intersection Y, the green part intersection the yellow part. This gives us our set A. But now X minus U, because U was open in X, this means that X minus U is closed. And so I was able to write A as the intersection of a closed set with my subspace Y. And this is exactly what I wanted to prove. Now let's have a look at the last theorem, which is actually very simple and also very similar to something that happens for the open sets. We have a subspace of X, so a topological space, and a subset with the subspace topology. If A is a closed set in Y and Y is closed in X, then A is closed in X. We had something similar for open sets. We said that a set was open in Y and Y was open in X, implied that A was open in X. So something very similar with closed sets. So our last theorem tells us that A will be written as the intersection of Y with F, where F is a closed set in X. I want to see that A is closed in X, so I want to prove that X minus A is open. I can just write X minus A as X minus Y intersection F. And now I think the easiest way to see this is that when I take the subtraction of one set with another, by definition, this is X intersection the complement of the set I'm subtracting. And this complement is the complement in X. So this, using the Morgan's law here, we have X intersection Y complement, complement in X, union F complement. And now I'm just going to do the distributive. I have X intersection Y complement union X intersection F complement. But now because F was closed in X, then F complement is open. And also Y is closed in X, so Y complement is also open. And so I'm taking the intersection of X with an open set. This is open, and the same here. And then I'm taking the union of two open sets, which proves that X minus A is open, and then A is closed in X. With this theorem, we finish the three properties that closed sets satisfy, and we finish the video. Remember that there are many ways to support us. On Patreon with a monthly membership, you can also donate small amounts of money on Ko-fi, or you can buy t-shirts in our mathematics t-shirts website.